visited the cemetery in 1914, writes, "I was amazed at the unsurpassed artistic value of the Khachkars, as well as the wonderful variety marking their reliefs. In the meantime, however, I was shocked to see that some of them had been broken during the construction of the railway." In September 1915, Scottish linguist and archaeologist Nicholas Marr gave an assignment to photographer Aram Varuir to work in the cemetery. In 1928, Lithuanian art historian Jurgis Baltrušaitis conducted research there. The tombstones of Julfa Cemetery fall into three groups. The first group includes the period between the 9th and 13th centuries. The second one, the 14th and 15th centuries. And the third embraces the time span between the early 16th century and the year 1605. All the Khachkars are carved of pink and yellowish stone. Having equal width from top to bottom, they are between 2 and 2.5 meters high. Their central parts are more deeply cut. The crosses and two-layer reliefs creating a peculiar contrast between light and shade. The cornices of the Khachkars often bear the representation of Christ, the Evangelists, and Holy Virgin. Below the cross, a finely carved rosette and the branches of a tree of life can be seen, while the lower part of the stone is engraved with an epitaph and a relief representing the deceased person. The cemetery was an eloquent witness to Julfa Armenia's glorious past. In the Soviet years, the cemetery became part of the territory of Nakhichevan, which had been annexed to the Republic of Azerbaijan. The Monuments Preservation Department of that country absolutely neglected it. Moreover, under state auspices, its tombstones were continuously broken to pieces and used as construction material. The investigation Agram Ayvazyan conducted in the cemetery in 1971 and 1973 showed that it retained over 3,000 Khachkars. Almost the same number was documented in 1987 when Dr. Murad Hasratyan and art historian Zaven Sarkisyan visited Julfa. In 1998, Nakhichevan's Azeri authorities started destroying the cemetery of Julfa with bulldozers to get rid of the countless Armenian monuments that attested to the Armenian identity of the territory and exposed the historical reality. Even UNESCO proved unable to prevent the annihilation of that part of Armenian cultural heritage. The photographs taken in autumn of 2002 revealed that the famous cemetery of Julfa did not have a single standing Khachkar anymore. Having never been held accountable for these atrocities, the Azeri vandals resumed the destruction of the cemetery between the 10th and 14th of December 2005. With the complicity of their army, more than 100 soldiers, armed with heavy hammers and pickaxes, reduced the Khachkars to a heap of crumbled pieces. The fragments were loaded onto lorries with excavators and thrown in the Arak's facing side of the railway. Thus, in December 2005, the Azeri authorities finally attained the goal they had been pursuing for many years, the purging of the three hills of the Khachkars. many scholars and art historians from all over the world had the privilege of seeing, admiring, and studying the magnificent memorials of Julfa. However, both present and future generations have been stripped of the opportunity of enriching their spiritual knowledge through Julfa. Once again, this terrible crime is the handiwork of the Turks, or one of the Turkish tribes called Azeri. In 1170, Turkish Emir Yeltkuz burned down more than 10,000 manuscripts in Babert region. In 1915, the Young Turks exterminated 1.5 million Armenians. Between 1998 and 2005, several thousands of Khachkars were crumbled to pieces in Julfa. Regardless of the period, the Turks and their fellow tribesmen, the Azeris, continue causing horrific damage to the civilized world. In early March 2006, Nakhichevan's authorities stationed a military base in the site of Julfa Cemetery. How long are these barbarities to continue? Must we always be reminded?